camp, Lalton, Lanton, Lalton. What do you call them, Lalton? Lanton. Yeah, let's go. Oh, somebody wants to hold the cross, right? May you take it back? Yeah, I will keep it there.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Ed Fox, the reader for this liturgy, and I welcome you to this celebration of the Eucharist on the vigil of the Feast of the Most Holy Trinity. Today's readings can be found on page number 194 of the Heritage Missal. The altar flowers, the altar bread and wine, and the sanctuary candle are in loving memory of Nicholas Lagunero, his anniversary from Diane and Kai Dumchowski and family. This mass is being offered for John, Andrew, and Michael Kruzewicz from Jane Jablonski and family. The second collection this weekend is for the Utility Fund. The second collection next weekend will be our monthly collection. Online registration for all students, both current and new, for the 2023-2024 classes is underway. Please visit our website for the registration. Prayer Shawl Ministry will have their monthly meeting on Saturday, June 10th at 9:30 in the school hall. Next Sunday, which is the Solemnity of the Body and Blood of Christ, we will have our annual blessing of Eucharistic ministers at all Masses. If you are a Eucharistic minister at the Sunday Masses and bring communion to the sick or aged, please come forward when all our Eucharistic ministers are blessed. Appreciation dinners for all ministries are scheduled in the month of June. Please see the bulletin for dates and RSVP to the office by Thursday, June 8th. We have opening from June through December for masses, altar flowers, altar bread and wine, and sanctuary candles. As we prepare for the entrance procession in the beginning of the liturgy, please greet those around you, and especially welcome those who are visiting or are new to the parish.
Please rise and join in the entrance hymn number 312, All Hail, Adored Trinity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We come together today to celebrate our triune God, one God and yet three persons. God the Father created the world and everything and everyone in it. God the Son was born into this world, a part of humankind, and chose to sacrifice his life to save us all. God the Holy Spirit was sent into the world by the Father and the Son to be with us always. In our limited imaginations, we cannot hope to truly comprehend this sacred mystery, but we join together in praise and thanks to God, Father, Son, and Spirit. My brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the mysteries of God's love for us, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, last
of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One.
Let us pray. God our Father, who by sending into the world the word of truth and the spirit of sanctification, made known to the human race your wondrous mystery, grant us, we pray, that in professing your true faith, we may acknowledge the Trinity of eternal glory and adore your unity, powerful in majesty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up to Mount Sinai as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, "The Lord, the Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity." Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, "If I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Glory and praise forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. And blessed is your holy and glorious name, praiseworthy and exalted above all for all ages. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you in the temple of your holy glory, praiseworthy and glorious above all forever. Glory and praise. Blessed are you on the throne of your kingdom, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forever. Blessed are you who look into the depths from your throne upon the cherubim, praiseworthy and exalted above all forever. Glory and praise forever.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice, mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, everyone.
Evening, Father.
The feast of the Holy Trinity is called the preacher's nightmare. Any amount of preaching you do every year, same Holy Trinity, and we still cannot get across the message to all. And in the seminary, they told us that our faith does not go against, our reason does not go against faith. And so I'll try to take you to the door of this mystery, but I cannot fully explain it. That is what everybody has done. They have taken us to the door of this mystery, but none of them was able to explain what this mystery is. And I will try to explain with analogy,
not the perfect ones, some images, and so they might help you to understand what we are trying to celebrate today. Have you seen that plant, shamrock? I think this is the image everybody has used in the past. St. Patrick used this image of the shamrock plant. It has three, it's a beautiful plant. It has three leaves and one stem. Three persons and one stem. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, three different thing people, but one stem. And that is the image, not the perfect analogy, but it somehow it explains, because St. Patrick used this, and I love the Irish because I was trained by the Irish Dominicans in India. My professors in the seminary were all Irish Dominicans, Order of Preachers, OP, if you know about them. And so I have a special regard, respect to them, and because they were very nice people, they trained us well, they made us good seminarians, and they lived, they taught us by their example, not just by preaching. So St. Patrick used this image, and so he tried to explain this Holy Trinity by that simple example of that shamrock. One, three leaves, one stem. Not only that, when we think about our God the Father, we always think about him as a creator, as a provider. And we have in our own life, our beautiful, our fathers who gave us, who made us, who created us, and also they also provided for us. I can speak about my own father. My father was a provider of the family. He worked 2-3 jobs. He got up in the morning. He rose at 4 a.m. and he went around doing jobs here and there, and he was a provider. And also my mom also was a provider because she also worked some jobs. And my dear friend, not only the provider, he was also my security. Whenever I was learning to ride a bike, he was behind me, trying to safeguard me, to protect me, to see that I don't get hurt, I don't fall. And so he was there behind me at the back, protecting me, holding my bike so that I may not fall and hurt myself. And he also did not allow me to climb any tree for the fear of falling from the tree and breaking my bones. All my friends, all my colleagues, classmates, everybody learned climbing trees, especially if you know what a coconut tree is, they go straight up. Coconut tree, it has no branches. There's a special art, special skill to climb a coconut tree. And I was trying to climb one day, and he came and gave me a smack at the back, at my bottom, and told me, get down. As a result, till today, I have never learned to climb a coconut tree because he did not allow me to climb a tree. He was so much protective about me. Whereas my friends, everybody knows to climb and pluck and bring down the tender coconuts, which are very delicious in summer drink. And so that was how my father was. Very protective. He was not only provider, but also protective. Also, when there is any threat in the town, maybe some storm or some lightning, thunder, or tsunami, he would gather us all together, take us to the basement, and he would protect us and safeguard us. So that is the image of my father. I have the memories, and so I can easily connect my Heavenly Father as a provider, creator, provider, taking care of me, protecting me in all my days, through all my dangers. So that is the one image of the Father. Secondly, the second person, Christ, Jesus Christ, is my brothers were like Mother Jesus Christ. I was lucky enough to have two older brothers. One is Justin, one is James and Justin. James older, he was a role model, and he was, he could fix things in the house, and he helped me with my homework, and also he He guided me to make my choices in life, like going to the college or go to seminary, and he was the main person to help me to decide about my vocation. Right now he's a deacon. So even now he is my best friend whom I refer to, and I discuss stuff with him. So he was my brother. Other brother was Justin. So he was also overprotective of me. And once it so happened that I was playing a game with my friends and somebody began bullying me. And he came and asked me, "What happened, Mark?" I said, "This guy is bullying me, not only bullying me, but hit me on my face. He beat me up." Then this guy went and hit him on the face, and then he began to protect me. So I was grateful to him being my protector. And now, my dear friends, I don't say that what he did is right. Jesus would never hit somebody in the face, but he was trying to protect me in that way. So I can connect now Jesus, my brother, when I have this experience with my own brothers. And now, Holy Spirit is the source of love. He is the love. Now you can connect my mother or my sister with the Holy Spirit, a feminine character here, but then it is the way it was. So my mother was the force of love in the family. And she was so, like for example, she taught me how to love people. She taught me how to be good. She taught me how to do good things to people. And that is the source of love that we have in the Holy Spirit. And once it so happened that she called me and said, "Look out at the window. It is 95 degrees today. And you see those men working in the sun there, 95 degrees. They may, in the paving of the road, so they must be thirsty. They might enjoy a cold drink. They might enjoy a lemonade. Why don't you go and give it some lemonade from them?" I said, "Sure, I will do." So, okay, bring that drink to them. "And there are some brownies here. Bring those brownies also to them, because they must be hungry and thirsty. They are working in the sun, 95 degrees. So, my dear friends, my mother taught me how to love people. And I saw one day lots of flowers somewhere in the house. I asked them, "Why these flowers here?" She said, "These flowers are for the people of the cancer patients in the hospital and for some pregnant women. And so would you like to go and give to the people in the hospital?" I said, "Yes." So I gave, I distributed flowers in the hospital. Also, pregnant women in the basement, I saw one day lots of flowers. "Why this? Are they for us?" "No, there is a lady in the neighborhood by the street. She is expecting a baby. So I would like you to go and give some flowers to that baby." So my dear friends, there are lots of examples like this where my mother taught me how to love. So I have given you the three different analogies, three different images: father, son, brothers, and the mother, the Holy Spirit. Now, my brothers were more than just friends. My brothers were just like, not just friends, but they were much more deeper. Because, as you know, blood is thicker. And they were the deepest source of encouragement, and they were my, not just friends, but my brothers, more than friends. So now my question to you is, when I look back at my family, I have seen the reflection of the Holy Trinity in my family. The Father's love, Creator, Jesus Christ, my brothers, and the Holy Spirit, the force of love, my mother and my sister. So now the question is, do you reflect that Holy Trinity in your families? Can your children tomorrow tell you that I have seen, or we have seen, that Holy Trinity, that unity in our family, just as there is it? So we don't have to explain the mystery of the Holy Trinity. We all know that, as I mentioned, is a nightmare to explain. We cannot use our reason to explain, but in our life, we have lived that, we have experienced that, and so you connect now that experience with the Holy Trinity. Can you, in your family, say that your children, can your children say tomorrow that we have experienced that love, that unity, and that oneness in our family? If not, probably we went some wrong somewhere. We need to put it straight, right? So as we celebrate this feast today, may this feast give us again, once again, the awareness that there is God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, three persons, three natures, but one stem, three leaves. Thank you. Please rise. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church.
I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sin. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life for the world to come.
Amen. Amen. Let us pray to the Lord, who is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness.
For the church, called to the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, may all who share one baptism find communion in the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the peoples of earth, children of God, who loves the world for the peoples of the Mideast, may we learn to live with each other in harmony and peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married couples, for parents and children, for those who are single, and for those who live in religious or service communities, may their love and respect for one another reflect the life of the triune God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For farmers who grow our food, that they may be blessed with good weather and a fruitful harvest, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this assembly, where our life is seen when we exchange the sign of peace, may our worship bear witness to the peace in which we live. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For John, Andrew, and Michael Kruzekiewicz, for whom we celebrate this Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful and gracious Father, you showed the fullness of your love when you gave your only Son for our salvation and sent down upon us the power of your Spirit. Complete within us the work of your love, that we who have communion in Christ may come to share fully the undying life he lives with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The offertory hymn is number 481, How Great Thou Art.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name. Sanctify by the invocation of your name, we pray, Almighty God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in a trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in the confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day, as with one voice they acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Frank, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you as their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on us, all the world, all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Thank you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter. May the body of Christ to keep me safe for eternal life.
The communion hymn is number 407, I Am the Bread of Life. I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you. Flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever, and I will raise you. You are. that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who has come into the world, who has come into the world, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last
day. Let us pray. May receiving this sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. Amen. May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy. Amen. Amen. May he turn his countenance towards you and give you his peace. Amen. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God. Thank you.
Please join me in the prayer to St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
I wish to congratulate all those children, teens, who received the sacrament of confirmation this morning. A special thanks to the teacher of our young teens, Mark Hewlett, and his helper, John Egan, and to our Christian formation staff, especially Cecilia Bowers, our Assistant Director of Faith Formation. We have now reached about 86% only pledged of our parish goal for the annual Catholic appeal. We still need to raise about $6,000. We are asked to invite those who have not made a commitment to do so. After being here for over 2 years, you know that asking for money is the least favorite thing that I have to do as your pastor. So far, about 120 donors have made pledges or outright gifts out of your parish with over 400 families. Thank you the ushers, thank you the Eucharistic minister, lector, music, altar server, and live streaming, thank everybody. Thank you and have a great week. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. The recessional hymn is number 505, Holy God, We Praise Thy Name. Thank you. say.